Oh.
Hey, you.
Hey.
Hey, dude, you good?
Yeah, I'm good. How are you doing?
Good. Are
you ready for the interview?
Thing is, mate.
Okay, what happened?
I'm hungry.
Oh.
I'm bloody hungry.
So
I think we might have to wait.
Okay,
before we do anything, to be honest with you. Like, there's no energy levels right now.
Okay, I mean, I wasn't super ready for it, but you know what? Let's try and do something. I want to please the musicians. I want to contribute, do my part. Okay, let's see what we can do about that. Do you want to just follow me? Let's
cool,
try
let's
and get
do
some
it.
Sort of...
Let's go, man.
See you. It looks nice.
Okay, guys. So, Or of Total Rock, and I have
hey,
the
yeah.
pleasure of meeting Adam and John of As Everything Unfolds. Wasn't really ready for this. I thought we were just going to have a normal interview, but you guys are hungry.
Yeah, man.
So,
we're hungry to rock.
Yes. I'm going to feed you with some questions. You're going to feed me with some answers.
Cool.
And we're going to see what comes out of this. I'm going to time you and give you points as well, just to make it interesting for me. But yeah, everything goes. So hopefully we're going to have some burritos at the end of this
yeah.
and not food poisoning. But you know...
you can't get food poisoning if you rock. Everybody knows
sure.
that's true.
Yeah. It's not food poisoning, you just surprise diarrhea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hello.
Okay, so you guys are going to start, help yourself to whatever. Watch your fingers and stuff.
Nah, mate.
But
we used to be chefs, mate. We knew what we used to do.
Okay,
yeah,
so actually,
surely.
Yeah, I've heard, we talked about a year ago, and you already mentioned
yeah.
that you're a foodie. So tell me about your on-road traveling food experience. I'm going to try and stand in the middle.
Yes, good idea.
So which one is actually the foodiest in the band? Because every single one of you says he's a foodie.
Probably. Yeah, like I guess. But like you love food.
I'm a close second.
I'm definitely a close
in the
second.
Grand, like
scheme of things. I don't know, man.
I think it's
like
the red water chicken story.
Oh my god.
I see. We're not cooking here. We're not multitasking.
None of us could be more. Oh, what's that?
That's chili sauce
rice
for chili.
You're going rice first.
We're just going to start with that.
Gonna, yeah, this is my base layer, so I can roll it up. John and I, are, you know, we love cooking and stuff. I used to be a chef a little bit, but Jamie is the true chef. He is Ratatouille reincarnate, right? This guy, when we were away recording, was it the first album?
Yes.
John and I had been in the studio. It was a hard day. We'd been recording. We got home. We were like, he was texting. He was like, "Oh guys, I'm gonna make a curry tonight." We were like, "Cool, chicken curry. That sounds amazing. Like we'll come over for that." Super excited, man. Hard day. We didn't get back till I don't know 8 or something, which is not that late, I guess, if you think about it. But like we kind of came back and everything, and it was like, "Oh, like he's cooking on the stove." And we looked in, and we were like, "Oh, that looks like an interesting kind of curry. Like it's red, that's for sure, and there's chicken in it." And then like we sat down to eat it, and there's a reason it's called red water chicken.
Because it was just red water and chicken and rice.
It was like
so watery. Jamie is the worst chef out of us all.
It was like watery tomatoes with chicken in it. And like, I mean, I felt bad because I was like, he spent a lot of time doing this.
We ate it, but like,
okay.
It's, I'll be honest with you. I wouldn't go again. I wouldn't eat there again.
In a restaurant, I would not be a customer.
But the thing is that on tour, you gotta kind of lower your standards between just having the same Subway every day,
yes,
or not having anything, or just making anything from scratch.
Yeah.
So who's your savior, or what's your go-to restaurant? What saves you and makes you feel like the flavor of home?
European McDonald's waffle fries. We don't have them. We don't have the waffle fries.
Mate.
Waffle fries.
Every time we go, we're like, these are so good. These are the best. I don't get why we don't do them.
Yeah.
It's better. I know they're like, oh, maybe they're unhealthier or something, but like, they are the best. I love waffle fries.
Is there no McFlurry curry or something like that in the UK?
No, not yet. The machine's always broken anyway. You don't get anything. Like, have a McFlurry, please. No, it's broken. All right. I won't have one. That's fine.
Rumor has it that they just don't like cleaning it. That's what I heard. It's never broken.
Yeah.
They just don't like cleaning it.
That makes me not want to get one, but like, I always get one.
So let's talk business a little bit. We're going to talk about food again, but there's a rumor that the album, the second album, is almost out. You keep on saying there's
that
a single
fake.
Coming
nah,
out. I spoke
fake.
To Charlie a
nah,
few months ago.
Fake.
There's nothing. You just love touring and you're like teasing us. So
yeah.
What is coming out?
We're building the ultimate hype.
Okay.
The album is very good. certainly is extremely nice and good.
I like it. I would give it nice out of 10.
Yeah, I would give it nice out of 10 as well.
A nice out of 10.
Nice out of 10. It's okay. Nice.
Is it recorded?
Yes. Could be. I love you. You're like, yeah.
Sorry.
Okay.
Maybe.
Perhaps.
Three peppers, bro.
Okay. Is there a video singles coming out? What can we... I mean, I'm feeding you here.
I feel really mean, but you'll never guess what we saw earlier.
Oh, no.
We got one of the drafts back for the video. Yeah,
okay. So there is a video.
I mean, sorry.
No.
There's at least a video.
There's definitely
perhaps
one video, maybe, possibly.
Okay.
Lovely shit.
That's garlic and curry.
Ooh, curry.
I'm going garlic. That's for the ice cream later, yes. So
garlic ice cream.
What can we expect? We really want to get to know more of the upcoming album. I heard Charlie a few months ago, we spoke at Full Force Festival, and she said it's more positive, which I found really interesting.
Yeah.
Because so many bands coming out of Corona, coming out of Brexit, coming out of the UK in general, the albums are not very positive. So yours is more positive than before. How did it happen?
We did the sad album of, and well, it wasn't a sad album. It was kind of, how would you say, Adam, how would you say?
It was
introspective, maybe. Yeah. It was kind of like reflective, and we were, you know, but from a sadder point of view, wasn't it?
This one's more, the next one's more like coming out from the other side of something bad
and being more positive in that way. But there's still touching of themes which are more negative. But yeah, it's out of the other side of whatever battle was being faced.
Is it something that you guys all relate to? Is it just Charlie writing it and you just agree with what she was going through? Is it you all feeling a bit more positive or grown up? Can I use that term?
Yeah, I think it is much more grown up, to be fair. I think it does rock. I think people are going to go, they've got ghostwriters.
Yeah, people will think
it's going to sound like we've got, and we haven't. I promise you that. You can check it.
Yeah, I cannot disagree with you while you're holding a knife, but okay. So what does it mean? Like, you're being more citizens of the world, maybe more grown up emotionally, musically.
I'm
trying to steal a scoop, so please help
me. It's more like grown up emotionally, but then like musically as well. It's sort of like, you know, when you hear like a young band, they've got a young band sound, but then like if you've been around for a little while and everything, like it feels mature. It feels like it's come of age.
Yeah.
It's 18 years old.
Yeah.
It can buy a whiskey. It's an 18 year old whiskey.
It's
you
had
know,
a bit of experience
it's
in life.
It's been out in the world.
We've
it knows what's going
for
on
a bit now.
So when is the album going to celebrate its 18th birthday and go party with us? This year, next year?
You can expect something this year.
Okay.
Something.
Okay, something.
You can expect something this year. Okay. I don't know. We don't know what we can say.
Yes. we're going.
It's really funny. Every time we do interviews like this, it's like, oh, what can we say? What can't we say? But like, so, keep your eyes peeled for the end of the year.
Yes, that's a good idea.
I would. And then it'll either be at the end of the year or be next year. It'll be, could be 2024.
Okay.
It's going to be like Chinese Democracy.
It's going to be...
Every year we're like, it's coming.
It's worth it, though. It's going to be worth the wait.
Okay. I think so. There's some of my favourite stuff on there to date, without question.
Okay, I'm just...
Without question.
I'm just hoping we're not going to get drunk with it while it's celebrating its 21st, like in the US. It's going to be like UK drinking age.
Yes.
So I'm looking forward to either the end of this year with some good stuff or the beginning of next year.
You will be.
Let's talk about something a bit more intense, let's say. I like utilizing our platform to try and make the music scene or maybe even the world a bit better.
Yes, I agree.
So something that I started talking to musicians over the last couple of months, toxic masculinity is such a big topic.
Oh, for sure.
Although even asking musicians about that, I got some comments from fans that they're not interested in that. So I feel like I'm going to talk about even more.
Nice.
So I feel like that's getting there. That's getting there. There's a tiny log in there. Yeah. By the way, you're making food for the other person. So.
Oh no!
So
there's loads of peppers in this. Oh.
Okay. Well, we'll see where it goes. But again, let's try and utilize our platform. You guys are two white men in a very manly, very white, very straight scene.
Yes.
But also Charlie is, to some extent, not what we just described, but dominating the scene. I've seen you guys live a few months ago and my jaw just dropped. So she very much belongs there, I feel like we can make it a bit more welcoming to other upcoming musicians, to fans. What was your experience with that, either as fans, either as musicians? I heard some interesting stories on a negative side from all angles. So yeah. What is your take as people that experience that? How do you go against that? What do you want to say to people watching us to make it more welcoming to everyone?
You just got to speak up, haven't you?
Yeah.
And like, if you see shit, just tell them to fuck off. So, can I swear?
Yeah, of course.
Well, I have now.
You should.
Yeah, but like,
when that happens.
If you're going to be a wanker, like, just fuck off. Yeah. We don't want you in our scene.
There's
no place for it. The most upsetting thing is just, like, fucking hell. It's just how slow the industry goes.
Yeah.
You know?
It's, like, do your fucking research. Like, if you have a band with a female singer coming, don't then tell her to get off stage when she's sound checking. Like, do your research, surely. Like, know what's happening.
It's not hard. Like, she's on the poster and she's on stage. Like, oh, get off the stage. It's like, she's coming to fucking sound check. Like, it's not. Bro, we, in some ways, we're not blessed by it, but because of Charlie, and obviously we're friends and everything, so we get to see it from both on a professional way and outside of life as well. And I feel like there's quite a lot of bands are just all, it's all men, isn't it? It's all the thing. They don't see it, and possibly they don't act on it, because it's like, if you don't see it, I guess you think, oh, it's not a thing, it's not happening, it's not this, that, the other. Because we get to see it, it's kind of like, well, that shouldn't be fucking happening.
Yeah.
We need to do something about that. We need to tell these people to fuck off. Don't book them on shows. Like, why would you book shows with someone who you know is a wanker? Like, I never get that. If you say something, and you know, if they're just sexist, or if they're an abuser, or they do whatever, don't fucking book them, man. Why would you? And don't, like, if you're in a band with somebody, and it comes out, get rid of them. Why do you don't want them there?
And also, hire more female touring crew, because they're literally sick.
They are the best. Danny, we miss you.
Yeah, we miss Danny.
I'm in charge. Like, why have you put me in charge, Danny?
On Download Festival, the pilot we had, the first download we played, the crew were all female, and it was amazing. Like, run way better than a lot of shows that I've seen with little man crew. Like, it's insane.
Well, I have a feeling that some of them will not volunteer, but step up to be part of it more if they feel more comfortable, more confident, more safe. Mm. So that's up to us as well. So it's not just to invite them, to actually make them feel like they belong there and that they're safe there. So I feel like talking about it is part of it. I feel like eating stuff is also part of it. So hopefully whoever needs to hear it will hear it, because it's part of bands. Bands are being outed for not being welcoming.
Yeah.
Promoters are being outed.
Yep.
Fans as well. Shows are being stopped to make people safe.
Yeah.
So hopefully we will stop hearing about those stories, not because we stop talking about it, but because it stops happening.
Yeah, great.
So hopefully the next time we talk, then you're going to tell me that everything is great.
Yeah. And I would love that.
Everyone is so nice.
It's again, like I said, it's annoying how slow the industry is, but on all fronts, you know, technologically, emotionally, fucking everything just seems to take like 10 years. Everyone goes, oh, let's not do that. And then it takes like 10 years to get rid of the people who are going, well, I actually want to do that or whatever. So I'm hoping that, like, I mean, we've been going for, I don't know, a while. We're probably coming up to a decade in some shape or form. And I'm hoping that in another decade, conversations like this will be like, yeah, of course.
I remember that
was a weird time that we all lived in and experienced, but like, thank God we don't do that anymore.
Well, yeah. Maybe we need to promote it on denim jackets. I think that will reach a wider audience.
Maybe. So that will battle work. Jacket patches.
Okay, so maybe just, that's the next merch.
It could be. Fuck sexism.
Okay, so I feel like you guys are ready to eat. I'm kind of scared of seeing the result. Do you want to present what you guys made?
Yes.
So does it have a name?
Mine is called John Cass, if he had no head or limbs. This is my torso.
Okay, catchy.
Yeah.
I can definitely put on a menu. Okay.
Yeah.
And Adam, what's the name of your dish?
I've made a new and improved ribwich.
Hold on. Oh.
It's a ribwich.
Okay.
If you've ever watched The Simpsons, this is exactly the same. This is a ribwich.
So what's in it? What's the secret ingredient, or are you not telling me?
Rock.
Okay.
My secret ingredient is great vibes.
Okay, that sounds great, healthy.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
That cross-section.
Amazing.
Give me the knife.
You not got a knife?
Oh, yeah, probably.
No, oh, you lost the smile, knife.
Thanks, hon.
Okay.
Right, I'm going to do a cross-section.
I'm scared of your reaction as well while you eat it.
You pay £6 for that.
Of course, yeah.
Mine has so much onion in it. Which onion is going to be amazing.
The roasted onions.
Oh, I forgot
about the secret ingredient.
Mine is my dream wrap. and I'm very sad I'm going to have to give it over to Adam.
Okay, so
I don't want
to are you going to share?
I don't like quack.
Are you going to swap hexes?
Actually, draw swap one. Swap one.
Yeah, let's swap one.
Okay, so you guys are going to give points to yourself and the competitor burrito.
Each other's one.
Yes.
We're doing each other's first.
Each other's first.
Okay.
Look at that. That's all right.
It's all right. That's all
nice
he gets.
Balanced.
Yeah. Don't like peppers.
Oh. Okay. Then that
the amount of times I've like... So whenever we write or together or we're just hanging out wherever, like if we're cooking, if I make something and there's loads of us and we just put peppers in it, you just see, I know which plate's his at the end because there's just loads of peppers just in a, like on the side of the bowl. I'm like, bro, just eat them. Like, how old are you now? Just eat
the
peppers.
I'm glad you didn't put mushrooms in because I really don't like mushrooms.
Oh, fried mushrooms, man. Cast iron grill.
This is why he's the foodie.
Mm. Okay, second one. Taste yours.
So that was okay.
Okay, just okay. That's all he gets.
Yeah.
So it's like a 3 out of 5.
Yeah, I'd say it was a 3 out of 5.
Okay.
If this is worse than yours. I'm going to be so upset.
Adam, by the way, how many points did you give John? I like how everything is really objective here. So John, does he get more than 3?
No, John gets more than 3.
Okay.
I'll give you 4, because it's a good rap.
Okay. But yours gets... A 4?
I'm only going to give it a 4, man. It's different. yours is more savoury. Mine's really sweet.
Yeah.
Mine feels like a chili, sweet chili summer wrap. Yours is more like a savoury, hearty kind of wrap.
Okay, so you give yourself 4 and John gets a 4 as well.
Yeah,
so,
I'll be okay.
I'll give myself a 5 and Adam a 3. Needs more onions.
Okay, so I think...
To be fair, I could have it more onions.
In this very objective test, okay, I think
like,
John
I'm
wins.
I'm just really nice and fair, and he's just like, oh, I'm the winner. Okay. John Cass forever. John Cass, what happened to John Cass for the people?
I've rigged the election.
So John, as the winner, you get to do the dishes. So
that's a fair trade.
I'm glad there's only like 2 dishes. Oh, there's 4.
Okay, guys, before we say goodbye, now that you're almost full and stuffed and calm, we talked about an album that may or may not be out at some point in the future.
It will.
We talked about a positive future, about telling people to just stop being assholes and inviting people and making them feel safe. What else do you want to say to listeners out there before we say goodbye?
Believe in yourself. You can do whatever you want to do, but you just have to believe, man. Like, if you're having a bad time, the sun's coming, I promise. I promise, promise, promise.
I want to say that music is easy and John Cass.
Hey, strong words from As Everything Unfolds. We got a lot of scoops that are not really scoopy, but...
That's scoopy. What kind of scoops are we supposed to... Like, I don't even know what we can say.
It's a bit of a release date.
Rocks. There's a bit of a release date. Yeah. It's... great, it rocks, it's mature,
it's happy,
it's kind of new metal.
Yeah. Ooh. Okay.
It's kind of new metal, man.
Okay.
But like, yeah, like it's kind of new metal. It's kind of new metal.
There's a bit of new metal.
There's a bit of rock.
There's your scoop. Yep. It's a bit of new metal. It's a bit of rock.
Okay.
There's more synths.
So I'm going to try and steal more scoops between burps after this. Guys, thank you very much. It's been an honor seeing you mess up food here. And thanks again.
Thanks for the raps.